Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Passionpreneur TV. Today I'm here with Jill Prescott and I'm very excited to introduce you to her. I just had a wonderful table session with you and it was so amazing. So I'm very excited to introduce you to everybody.
Thank you.
So, Jill, tell me, you've been doing what you've been doing now for about 3 years, but before that, before we start talking about it, what were you doing before?
Well, I've had a few lifetimes, but the one just previous to this, I was 20 years as a financial services manager in the car business. So you would think actually that that's a really big leap to go from that to this, but you know, I couldn't have asked for a better training ground for what I do now, because every possible human being walked through those doors in that 20 years, right? I mean, I was dealing with every person out there, every bit of humanity, and they're coming in and they're making probably the second largest purchase that they're going to make in their life. So imagine yourself in that situation. There's stress and anxiety. There's fear. There's excitement at the same time. So really, I was helping people even back then figure out a way to still be happy and come together in one of the biggest things they were doing in their lives. So it was massive training ground for me.
So I know you're all dying at home to know exactly what Jill Prescott does, and she's about to tell you right now.
Oh boy. What I do is I assist people to transition in their lives. So oftentimes they'll come to me because they're not happy in their career, or another big one is they're kind of stuck relationship-wise, and not necessarily even just in marriage, just all of their relationships, family dynamics, all of that kind of thing. And right now, the biggest, and probably for the last year, the biggest reason people come is because they're lost. Like they feel this really weird energy going on. They're just not happy in their lives. Lots of times they have everything, money, the house, the husband, the kids, everything looks really cool and awesome from the outside, and they're not happy. So what's happening for those people is they're coming into consciousness. So they're starting to get that what life has been told to them that's going to make them happy, what they've grown up with thinking they're going to be happy with, they're finding out it's not it. Mm-hmm. It's not all of it. And they're also realizing that the stuff that they've been carrying from their past weighs a freaking ton, and they're sick of carrying it. So a lot of what I do is helping people really understand that when they can be really responsible for themselves and their entire lives, and I mean every bit, the dirty, the nasty, the what they've been blaming everyone else for years, they actually get control back. So they can let go, release, forgive, shift their reality in that way, and it opens up like this massive whole other space for them. So, yeah.
And is that what happened to you? You were working away for 20 years and you went, hey, wait a minute, I have all these things on the outside, but in the inside, I'm completely unfulfilled. And this awakening of consciousness is like, it's almost like a veil that gets lifted, right? And you're like, oh, there's other things that I feel and think and want. And then you go on the journey because it totally doesn't end there, right?
That's right. And you know what? Honestly, I know for me, and it's true for most people, the car, the house, the money, the relationship, a lot of times, if you haven't come to it from a conscious place in your life, it's just a big fat sham. For me, it was a massive sham. I looked good from the outside. And there was nothing behind it but upset, confusion. My marriage was crumbling. I was in debt up to my, it was just ridiculous. And I hated going to work.
That's
you know,
the big thing.
It was right really, there. Really tough. Yeah. And I'd actually been aware that I was not supposed to be doing that anymore for quite some time. But I had a really, really strong, what's commonly termed an inner critic. Mm. And I had that since I was very, very young. I actually thought that I was stupid. And that was the game running the back in my head all the time. So the idea of leaving this business that I was really, really good at the time and just like starting something else, it all came right back up. Like, I can't do anything else. It's amazing that I'm doing this. And why would I leave something that's making me all this money? Well, it was making me all this money that I was giving away and lending and spending, and I didn't really have anything anyways, right? So, yeah.
And now that you've gone on your own personal journey, and it's been years now that you've been doing what you do, how do you assist in helping others?
Yeah. So there's a few different ways. I would say that the most profound experience when you come to see me is when we go on a journey together. So I do a 3-month package with people.
Okay.
Essentially, they're working with me for 3 months solid, and we do not only one-on-one sessions, we do 9 over that time, but they're also, I'm like completely available to them for those 3 months. And I'm certified in clinical hypnotherapy. I do something called harmony integration processing, which is a psychology-based process. I'm a certified intuitive and an energy worker as well. So, and those are kind of like the certifications. And then there's other stuff that have come into my, they've come into my being, or I guess I've remembered them, really, is what I'd like to really put across to people, is that there's nothing to be learned. It's only remembering. So it's like the gifts that I open myself to have come flooding in, and I use those to really assist people in their growth and whatever they want to do. So when we're kind of on that 3-month journey, I'm using all of those things to really take them from one to the next, and it really is a journey.
Beautiful. Yeah. And I know you have your Soul Sister group.
Yes.
Where you get together with the ladies.
Yes.
Once a week and do a journey with them too in a sacred circle opening
That's right.
up. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
And then you also do speaking.
I do.
Yeah.
You know what happened? The very first time that I did it, I realized that you could stand on a stage in front of 50 people, 60 people, 100 people, and you could connect with the person at the back of the room. And there's so much that really can make a difference for people. And sometimes it's one thing, like one sentence, and your whole life alters. So if I'm on stage in front of 100 people, there's a chance that 20 of them are going to get something that changes their lives from that. That's a heck of a lot more effective than one-on-one.
Totally. You're a big believer in us all having our own knowledge and power, and it's just tapping in and getting to the source of it.
Totally. You're your own guru, because I really believe that when you do that, when you love yourself deeply, you have access to all the answers within you. That doesn't mean that you don't want people around to lead you, to show you the way, to open things up for you. I have coaches and mentors, and I always will for all of my life. However, the best of the coaches and the best of the mentors are going to help you look inside and find out what's going on for you personally and get to your own truth. The ultimate power in everything is love. For me, that's really it. So I want you to fall in love with yourself.
I love it.
Yeah.
Of course I do. It's so great. Good for you, girlfriend. You just taught me how to high five, too. You got to look at the elbows.
Look at the elbows.
If you'd like to learn more about Jill, please follow her link here below. And I encourage you to follow in your own heart's desire, of course, and explore your inner journey. Find out what it is that fires you up, which makes you feel alive and passionate for life. I mean, what else are we here for?
Follow your bliss, man.
Just follow your bliss. Take it on. If you'd like to be on the show, please drop us a line. And I am Adara. And of course, I dare you to be different.